And Devorah, thank you that the whole year, nephews, Domotijan, Domoti Uka, nephews, cousins said Kaddish. Thank you, it's a big thing. It's a big thing, and I'm the witness. They said Ashkavod and Kaddish, and every time, Mr. Basalilov, I don't see him now, and also other ones, grandchildren, great grandchildren, everybody. You did an amazing job. Also, Abo HaKohen Ben Chalmoch. Also, Frida Bat Devorah. And also?
Zina Bat Sarah Aulov.
Yes, I was thinking about the last name. Thank you. They should be in Gan Eden praying for us. And the year should pass successfully, Be'ezrat Hashem. Only in your houses should be happy, happy occasions.
Amen.
Thank you for sponsoring this shiurim. This is very important shiurim. From LA, from Israel, from Brooklyn, from different states. People calling and saying thank you for this shiurim that they are learning and they are getting connected to Hashem. With this, I want to say, Refuah Shlema, Rochama Perel Malkalea, but Chana Serel. And also should be Refuah Shlema to Daniel Ben Miriam Chedva. Zivuk Agun should be Chatuna Be'atzlacha to the proper girl, huh? V'gam Nechadam Bat Panina, Refuah Shlema. V'gam Nechadam Bat Farecho. Should be Refuah Shlema to everyone. Before I will continue, I want to say tomorrow night. Refuah Shlema, Israel Ben Basanda. Tomorrow night is the night of Tu Bishvat. The night of Tu Bishvat, we said yesterday. I'm sorry, we said it last week. Remember Tzereh? Tzereh, remember two dots? That was Yetzirah. Remember that? Remember. And this holiday is the holiday of Yesod. Yesod means foundation. In this world, foundation of the house is woman. Foundation of life is Hashem, of course. And foundation of survival is land. Rain hits the ground and the land gives fruit. We will make, that's Tu B'Av, number one. Number two, we will make all this on time, Be'ezrat Hashem, as soon as COVID will be gone. Be'ezrat Hashem, we are writing on the calendars all the things that we are missing for the couple events, shurim, connections, all these parties that we cannot do now, we're putting on the calendar, and Be'ezrat Hashem, when we are able to do, we will not miss nothing. Everything will be there. And Be'ezrat Hashem, you know, now occasions coming up with my daughter's engagement and so on. Be'ezrat Hashem, after everything, we will put everything in the structure, how we did 3-4 parties a year, it will come back Be'ezrat Hashem soon. I want to ask you a favor. Tomorrow night, prepare a lot of good fruits, vegetables, bread, wine on the table. And then make structure of Maga Esh. Maga Esh stands for Mem is what? Some say Mezonot, some say Motzi. Take Mezonot or Hamotzi, make Natilat Yadayim, make Bracha on the bread. Then, Gimel stands for Geffen. Try to get wine from Eretz Israel. Because the land of Israel, Hashem was praising through 7 fruits. Ayin is Eitz. You take then what? You take olives. Or you take dates. Or you take grapes. Or figs. Or pomegranate, and you put it on the table. One person says one time, Mezonot, Geffen, Etz. Another person could say Etz. The third person could say Ha Etz. You understand? So you make one bracha once. Have kavana, and whatever grows on the tree, you say Ha Etz. You think about everything. And this gives you strong parnasa, refuah shlema, health. You want parnasa in business. All these fruits that you make bracha, it goes throughout the year. Then, If you're not married yet, think about Hashem should send you a good wife. Those who are not married, girl, she should think Hashem should send her a good husband. Be'ezrat Hashem. This, only tomorrow night, this special gate opening for these prayers. Don't miss it. Then, pray for Lulav, Etrog, Hadas, and Aravot. These four species and that you will be shaking on Sukkot, that they should be kosher. When you pray for them, now, today, tomorrow night. This night, you pray for fruits, to be fruitful, to get married, Be'ezrat Hashem, should be Zivug Hagun. And those who really, really, really want to go to Buffalo, I'm telling you, I'm in a mood to go because I feel like really quarantined. This is my 11th year that every year on this time, season, you will never find me in New York. I go or Israel or Florida. This is first time after 11 years where I could not come up with any trip because there was too many occasions, Baruch Hashem. And therefore, I'm very crazy to go to Buffalo. If you really have young guys and young girls who want to get married, gather them as soon as we are 50. We will make a trip. We will go to Buffalo here. Rabbi Nathaniel offered his cars. Be'ezrat Hashem, Rabbi Nathaniel, yes? He offered the cars. Look what funny, guys. You think I'm joking with you? I'm not joking. Two guys were driving the van. One guy said after 3 hours, he says, guys, I'm tired. He comes out to the gas station. Second guy takes over. These two guys within 1 week got married. Last week, one of them, and 2 weeks ago, second. Baruch, look at the miracle, open miracles. It's unbelievable. And that was couple number 7. There's 17 more couples to get married within 2-3 months. Be'ezrat Hashem, all those who went to Buffalo. So those who wants to go... try to get these 7 fruits that we said. Wheat, barley, and then olives. Dates, grapes, figs, pomegranate. Okay? Take these 7 fruits and then add other fruits, whatever you didn't eat. Now, what if I'm making bracha on something that grows on the tree and I never ate it before? First I make bracha ha'etz, then shechiyanu, and then I'm eating it. Okay? Make sure you make shechiyanu. Make sure you have something new to eat tomorrow, Be'ezrat Hashem. All your wishes should come. True, Be'ezrat Hashem, tomorrow night, do not miss it. Now, let's continue. Last week, we were learning about 7 bottom sefirot. Do you guys remember last week we learned?
Yes.
3 we finished before Ketel, Chochma, Bina, we finished. Then we went to 7 bottom ones. 7 bottom ones are connected with Avraham Avinu, Yitzchak Avinu, Yaakov Avinu, Moshe Rabbeinu, Aaron HaKohen, Yosef HaTzadik, and David HaMelech. Very good. Today, we're going to... We did Chesed last week. Chesed was who? Chesed was... Unconditional love. Put it over there, please. So, we don't bother it, and it doesn't bother us. Now, Chesed was Avraham Avinu. Let's see. Good, no problem. This means Besiyata Dishmaya with God's help. Now, Chesed, number 1 is Chesed. I'm going to write in English. This filot, first 3, no dead person comes Gilgul. Anytime you hear Gilgul, only Gilgul comes in 7 bottom ones. First 3, nobody comes. Why? Because this is all high level.
Can you repeat what I didn't
hear? One more time. We have this world created with 4 elements. Okay, I'm going breaking through, so everything should be clear to everyone. And Rabbi Ilan is in the house. We will have fun. Dat Cham, write down. Dat Cham. One more time. There are 4 elements that God created the world with. No, people cannot see. No? One is different, second is different.
No, they can see it. The camera's facing. No, they can see it. It just, this one is cut off.
Okay. There are four elements that Hashem created this world. That's Ham, Domem, Tzomeach, Chai, Medaber. Molo Rachamim. I'm explaining from the beginning to make sure everything is simple and you will enjoy it. Okay? That's Ham. Molo Benjamin, you with me? That's Ham stands for four elements. Hashem created everything in the world. Four things only. What is Domem? Domem. Those who want to write in Hebrew, this is how you write it. Domem is the rocks and water. How they say? Unmovable thing. You cannot move it. And it doesn't grow. It stays the same. Rocks and water. This is first thing that Hashem creates the world with. Second is Tzomeach. Tzomeach is grass, trees, fruits. This is Tzomeach. Something that grows. It doesn't stay the same all the time. It's small grass becomes big tree. Small fruit becomes big fruit. The third one is Chai. Chai means living thing, means animals. This is a first living thing, but not complete. Why? Because cannot talk. Animals don't talk. Ah, you tell me, I heard parrot talk. Shalom, Alechem, Shabbat, Shalom. How you know? It doesn't talk. It knows how to rule his... use how his...
Vocal cords.
But it doesn't mean speaking. We are speaking. We have Hashem's spirit that we speak. Birds, they have only vocal cords, know how to do chick, 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 and become Shabbat, Shalom, you know, but they don't talk. Now, number four is Medaber. Medaber is what? The one who speaks person. Look at this. According to some opinions, those who explain Zohar, they say, when person passes away, by the way, I don't know who. Somebody, through Moshe Tzadikov, my neighbor, on Friday, sent me four different books. One book is about the life story of Rabbi Ovadia Yosef. And over there, Rabbi Ovadia Yosef says how his wife came to other people in their dreams, saying things like, go bring my husband house besamim, because he doesn't have enough 100 brachot. And Ovadia Yosef says, because my wife, he says, about himself, came to your dream, I know my wife is in Gan Eden. He says, Rabbi, what are you saying? He says, look, my wife comes to your dream, he says, and she cares about who? About you, Rabbi, he said, about you. She comes to the dream and she cares about her husband. When that person, listen good, I never knew this before in my life, I learned it last week. When that person comes in a dream and he cares about you or cares about somebody else, it shows you that person is in Gan Eden. Why? Because he doesn't care about himself. Once they don't care about themselves, means they are in a good spot. I did not know this part. Once they don't, if they say, listen, I'm cold, no good. If that person cries, like, you know, no
sir,
good.
Can I ask you, I'm sorry.
Yes, sure.
Did you not tell us in the last previous lesson that people don't come in your dreams?
Who said that?
You.
I never said that.
I guess somebody else
was. Yes, you did somebody else. And I'll prove it to you.
No, I just want to make sure. I heard that somewhere.
I'll prove it to you. People do say that. They say, angel comes to your dream. This is not true. That's not true. Dead people do come to dreams. And I witnessed it. And I even remember when I was a kid, my father used to go to Levayot and say, listen, if within the year you see the relative comes to your dream, put the candle. Say, Lunishma, put the candle. Why? Because sometimes when they come to the dream saying that they're okay, sometimes they come to the dream saying it's not okay. Still, Nen Hashem Nishmat Adam, Hashem's candle is the soul of a person. So when you put the candle, you always benefit the soul. So listen carefully. There are three, since we're talking about dreams, listen, whatever comes to my brain today, I'm going to just give it to you. Because I know it doesn't go anywhere. It just goes to you and you will enjoy. There are three types of dreams. This is the whole night. This is 10 p.m. and this is 6 a.m. Right? It divided on three. There are three types of dreams you can have. Dream number one, because of thoughts.
Daily run.
Daily run, thoughts. This is not true, fake. So whatever you see till almost 1 o'clock in the morning, all fake.
How do you know what time you see the dream? I mean, you're sleeping. How do you know what time?
You're right. You wake up in the morning.
Sometimes you don't. I have dreams. I don't wake up.
Don't believe in it.
If let's say you woke up and you see the time is 12:05. It's something that you were thinking all day about. Then there is second type of dream. It is called dream because of demons. Why? Because after 12:45 in the morning, after 12:30, 12:40 in the morning, demons get up. So they cause you problems sometimes. Okay? Second is demons. This is also
fake
dream. From 3 o'clock, 3:30, 4 o'clock in the morning, 4:40, like when the morning rise gets up, like 4:40, 4:30 in the morning, that this is a true dream. This dream comes to you from who? Malach, angel. When you see dreams about 4-5 o'clock in the morning, hello? Yes.
Let's say there's those people that they only go to sleep at, let's say, 3 o'clock in the morning. And right away they see a dream. Does that go on to the second category?
If they see until 3:45, it's here. All fake.
Okay. What about the people who work at night and in the morning they sleep and they see a dream? How does that
during work? The day, yeah. When you're sleeping during the day. Let's say you work in hospital, you work at night and you sleep during the day. What do you do? How long do you
sleep? From here.
Okay.
From here until sunset, all true dream.
Whoa. But what if it's daylight?
It's good to work the night shift.
All day. Day dreams are true.
Oh, all day?
All day. Yes.
Why is the time so important?
Very good. Thank you. Person's brain. I'm sorry. Marsha. Says on Gemara Brachot. Gemara Brachot says, three times at night, Hashem sits on his chair and roars like a lion. And says, oy, 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 what happened to my Beit HaMikdash? What happened to my children? I threw them out of Eretz Israel. Three times at night. Once Hashem screams on this part at night, once Hashem screams on this part, and one on this part. Wow. So one thing, I'm explaining you. Why three times? Because there are three watches the whole night. The whole night is divided on three, says Gemara Brachot. This is from page 3a. First one is compared to what? First one is compared to?
A donkey.
Donkey. Very good. Second one is compared to?
Dog.
The third one compared to?
Who wakes up for the mother.
Those who were in Sovietsky service, you're going to appreciate now. I was living in Samarkand, and Uzbeki, Tajiki, they would bring from Kishlak fruits, vegetables to sell in Machala. They would come with their donkeys. If it's Friday, they would come Thursday night. The whole night, starting from 10 o'clock at night, you hear, donkeys would scream, 20 blocks. I grew up like this. I didn't grow up in Kishlak. I never saw a donkey law. But I used to hear this. Once I said to my mom, Mommy, what is this? They said, my mom says to me, donkey over there screaming from this goyim. This time at night, they scream. You know, when I read this Gemara first time 20 years ago, I remember that piece. I remember that time. I said, wow, Hashem made me hear this. Thank you, Hashem. Like, you know, in the morning you wake up today, if you have a zechut to be living within 3-4 blocks, somebody who has a rooster, you hear kukurikoo, you wake up, you say, Baruch Ata, Anoten Lesechri, Binala Ochin, Ben Yomu Menlala. What the rooster say? Kum Ka'ari, Kum. He says, hey, get up. Get up like a lion. Get up. Kum. Get up, Ka'ari, like a lion. Kum. Get up. So now, the first night is corresponds to donkey. Why donkey? Because person is physical. We are physicals. We wake up in the morning, we think about work. We eat. After food, again work. These all physical things. So when you go to sleep, your brain for four first hours thinking whatever you did in physical world. Khomri, it means donkey. So whatever dreams you see over here, it all has to do with what? What you were thinking all day. Physical activity. So this is not true dreams. Make sense?
Yes.
Second one is the demon time. After the midnight, demons get up. I'll give you proof. Person was sick. COVID-19! I call him and I say, huh? I call so-and-so, how are you feeling? He says, you don't understand, Rabbi. All day I don't have fever. As soon as it hits 1 o'clock in the morning, his fever goes. Why? I said, don't worry, you'll be fine. If I say to him, demons make it to go up, believe me, it's going to end up not good. It's going to end up. No, he's good already. This is what I'm saying. He's good already. He's cured already. So bottom line is, as soon as sun goes down, this is the judgmental time. But 1 o'clock at night, demons get up. This is why, unfortunately, Chas v'Shalom, though, 90% people pass away from 1 o'clock in the morning till 5 o'clock in the morning. Why? Because this is the demon time. Pressure. Do you understand? Of course, this is also good time. Also, David HaMelech would get up at the midnight and say, Hashem! Midnight, yeah? Let's go, Rachamim now. But it also, you should know, it's a demon time. So from 1 o'clock, from 12:40 until like 3:40, 4:20, this is a demon
domain.
Whatever you see, dream there, not true. Now comes the third one. You already not tired. You're not thinking about work. Demons are gone. So what's there? Malach. Comes angel and gives you a dream. I'll give you a good example. There was one rabbi. He sees dream in Russia, Poland. He sleeps. I love this dream. I love this story. It's so good. His name is Rav Nachman. He sleeps at night. Comes Malach and tells him, Rav Nachman, if you go under the, I don't know, George Washington Bridge, and you start digging over there, you will find one pitcher of gold. He wakes up in the morning and says, Chai Guftan Guftan, you know. Goes to sleep. Second night, he sees the same dream. Now, Nachman, if you go with the lapata, with the shovel, and you will dig under the George Washington Bridge, you will have one pitcher of gold. One, two, three, this, four, this. He notices, I'm annoyed already. Every day I see this dream. He took the Shaul, and he start going and start digging. Police officer comes, huh? What are you doing here? Horrible would actually. What are you doing here? He says, you know, I'm sorry. I'll tell you the truth. I'm a rabbi in the community, and I should dream every day. They tell me, come George Washington under George Washington Bridge. If I dig, I'm gonna find a pitcher of gold. He says, you crazy. I see for 3 years in a row. Police officer tells him, I see for 3 years in a row a rabbi's house. In his field, he has three trees. Under the second tree, if he's going to dig, he's going to find a picture of God. I don't go to Rabbi's house and dig. Rabbi looked at him and said, Ibi, this is a sign from Hashem to me, you know? He says, no, you're right. All the jokes are fake. He started digging under the second tree and he found a picture of God.
Did he give that officer permission?
You confused?
What about under the bridge?
That was nothing there. That was the sign for him to get information from the police officer to go and dig in his house. Okay, let's go further. Bottom line. Huh? How are you sleeping? Nice. You know, two guys went to the Babich Rebbe. He gave them bracha to have baby boys, right? In a year, one had it. Second one didn't have. He goes to Rebbe, says, Rebbe, I didn't have. He says, I was a kalasko kupilti. He says, on kupil kalas, tishni kupil kalas. Okay. Brothers, can we go further?
Please.
Yes. Be'ezrat Hashem, within 9 months, we should come here for the Nisim Sanz breed.
Amen.
Now we'll go further. Package deal. Now, bottom line is, the third one is the true. We spoke about, okay, so person who left the world, if he has children, who says Kaddish, Ashkavot, nephews, brother, okay, say Kaddish, Ashkavot, that person goes to Gan Eden. Sometimes people don't say Kaddish, don't keep Shabbat, don't keep Torah mitzvot, so that person, he is in the one level and he stays in one level. Then Hashem says, listen, there is no one to raise you. I want you to raise yourself. How? He goes as a person once. He comes over here. Medaber, as a person. He comes, Hashem says, if you grew up in a Klal Yisrael's house, and you kept Torah mitzvot, and you did Shacharit Micharvit, and you put tefillin, you fixed it, you, as tzaddik will go, now you have Gan Eden.
One second, we're talking now about dead people, right?
Yes. What if person comes to this world and he didn't fix himself? You're telling me it kosher says, etanid lemine avrat. You say, listen, there's shacharit. He says, astav mine pakoi. There's tefillin. He says, I have allergy from this. Like, you know, always when you put excuses. And you know what? You trust him because you say, hi, okay, okay. But he doesn't understand these things hold him back from fixing himself. But it doesn't come as a person more than three times. One, two, three. More than three doesn't come. That's all. He didn't fix it after three times. He comes as a chai. What chai animal? He comes as a... So the question is, there's 100 animals. Why you decide always to buy that animal and make shechita? You know, even I thought in America now, you know, American life, chickens are in the store. You don't need to buy cow, you don't need to buy sheep. No, I'm wrong. There are rabbis, twice a month, they take 5-6 people, they go to College Point, they take a cow, they buy a cow, there's 4-5 cows, says, I want this cow, they take the cow, they make shechita. Why they do that? Because Hashem says to the cow, oh, if a Klal Yisrael buys you, makes bracha on you, you have fixing, you have Gan Eden. If he doesn't fix you, then you die, you come as a cow second time and the third time. Doesn't happen, let's say it doesn't happen, goy boring. And he made shechita from the back, ah, like, you know, oh, shit, shechita, banomash. And animal died, never, nobody fixed, no bracha you can make, that's all. Three times animal doesn't fix, it doesn't come as a chai anymore, doesn't come as an animal anymore. What comes as a? Fruits. This way, we go on Pesach. We do Birkat HaElanot, we do blessing for the trees. Why? Do you know, from Arizal's story I learned, when Arizal would go to the field to make brachot, he would go specially to many trees field. Why? Because he would say, in every tree there's certain thousand neshamot. I need to fix. You know how many people went to the war? Let's say a person was alone in the house, and he never was able to get married, and he never had child. And never had brothers in the war, World War II, Israeli war, another war. And there's no one to say Kaddish. So these people, they come on the trees and they wait 1 year until Rabbi or Tzaddik comes, opens the tree, bracha, and makes bracha on the trees and fixes him. When he fixes him, he goes then to Gan Eden. This is the reason we take everything, we make brachot. We take everything, we make bracha. Why we make bracha? We're fixing the object. So this is what? Tzomeach. Sometimes neshama comes on the tree, sometimes neshama comes on the grass, and sometimes neshama comes on the fruits. Whoever makes brachot, he fixes himself. You know, there was a once, by Chafetz Chaim, a lady was eating semichki. You know semichki? Semichki, small thing. She usually makes bracha on the seeds. But now she said, let me take one. She was cleaning rice and she found one seed. She opened the seed and she ate without bracha. Without knowing, in that seed there was somebody's neshama. And that was a man. Then she fell down. Her throat became like this. Her neck swelled up.
Swollen.
She couldn't speak. Her child came and said, ah, mama, just for me. She says from the worst man. Pazavi Chafetz Chaim. Got scared. He called Chafetz Chaim. Chafetz Chaim said, I will blow shofar. The only time I will know that neshama left is the window and the door on the glass on the window cracks. And he started praying. He said, no, you still here? Yes. Praying again, hour, two, three, until the window cracked. Tah! He said, okay, now neshama left.
She didn't need enough to make a brach anyway. It was for making a brach.
Huh? My friend, when Gemara says not enough to make bracha, means bracha charona, bracha rishona, even kolshu you have to make bracha rishona. What are you saying? Asur le'anot me'olam hazeh b'lo bracha. Page 35, Gemara bracha, my friend. Look good next time. Let's go further. Dalet. Dalet is what? Tomem. Oh, sometimes fruits. Fruits. We eat no bracha. Now, neshama comes as what? As in the water. In the water. Person takes water, says, Shakon. Did you ever see our rabbis make bracha? Baruch atah Hashem, what's so hard? Drink water, big deal. No, there's neshamot here I'm fixing. Elokeinu melech haolam shehakol niya bidvarno, and then drinks water. Everybody says amen, then he drinks water. This is when you fix that neshama. So here we spoke about it. Now let's go to next step. We did before chesed, huh?
What about the rocks?
Rocks. Sometimes, there's many, many different reasons. Sometimes certain Rasha needs to get punished. Hashem puts the rock for him to fall from. When he steps on the rock and he gets hurt, that time this rock fixes himself. Hashem puts rocks, or sometimes it's negative rock, but there's sometimes positive rock. Do you know, in Valojana Rebbe, when he made yeshiva of Valojan, that yeshiva had every student big talmid chacham. So the other yeshiva opened up, they came up to him and they said, listen, how are you so successful that all your students are talmidei chachamim? He said, before I opened the yeshiva, I was crying 6 months. And then, with that tears that I had put on the rock, I took the rock and I put first foundation to the yeshiva. So that rock was fixed. Do you know, always you have to make a big deal when you build a big synagogue to put the first rock. You have to make a ceremony for that. Why? Everybody has to cry, everybody has to learn Torah in order to have good fruits afterwards. What do you think? Yeshiva just comes, somebody opens a certain... No, you have to work hard from the foundation to make everything solid. This is how Aaron Cutler was successful, and now you have Lakewood, the whole Lakewood. How it opened up? No, Aaron Cutler. Before was there like a Harlem. Worse, yeah. Сто процент. Many times. You have prakol. You have how you say that? Flat tire. You have flat tire, or you don't have enough gas. You have to come out by the gas station, and you walk around. You say, "Oh, it's getting dark. Let me say one te'elim." Or today, I was driving in New Jersey, and it was snowing like crazy. Dark view, you don't see nothing. You're forced to say Te'elim. Why Hashem makes say Te'elim? Because in this area, you need to save certain neshama. And this is what you're saying. You know how many times people go travel place to place, and they sleep overnight, and they make shiurim over there? Why? To fix the neshamot that are there. And this is very big fixing. Now, Rabbi, let's go to next step. Yes.
If you have troubles at home, Rabbi.
Huh?
If you have troubles at home,
yes.
Somebody falls, something happens. That's yes. Something you could do also, right?
Yes. I would tell you like this: never forget, never. If person takes 20 minutes before he goes to sleep, he learns 20 minutes. Next all day is protected, and Shalom Bayit way is also protected. If you want to have good Shalom Bayit, never go to sleep until you learn 20 minutes. What Shalom Bayit? Arguments between husband and wife. Normal people do argue, but when arguments don't go overhand, how you say, out of hand. 20 minutes before you go to sleep. Yes?
I just want to get back to the rocks. Does the rocks have any correlation to when you go to a cemetery and you put the rocks on the person?
Yes. We spoke about it like 3 weeks ago. When you put the rock on the grave, by the way, I spoke on the Levaya. Of the mother, I spoke on the Levaya. Why do we put rak? Rak stands for 3 letters. If you want, write it down on your phone. You will never forget this.
Sure.
Even. Even means rak.
Stone.
Aleph stands for Av. Av means father. Bet is
Ben.
Ben is son. Nun is Neched. Neched is grandson. The only person who makes from father to son to grandson generation go is a woman. This is why we put rock, saying, I'm putting this because my mother raised me right. Whatever my father began, I'm going to continue. My father kept Shabbat, I'm going to continue. My father said brachot, I'm going to continue. My papa начинал делать митву, я буду продолжать. My papa начинал учиться Тору, я буду продолжать. Я это не оставлю. Почему? Потому что chain cannot stop. By the way, Rabbi Gavriel, вы митву на Shabbat. Thank you. Let's go further. Мы можем продолжать дальше, братья. Мы не а нехед, grandson. Okay, we'll go further. Yeah, everything's clear, solid. I could erase the board. We are holding on chesed. Now we go to Gevura. You ready? It's Chag Avinu. Let's go. I hope they don't cause some trouble. Okay. Second one is Gevura. Chesed is Avraham Avinu. Who's Gevura?
Very good.
Strength.
Gevura. Strength.
T there or no T?
T before the H.
Yeah.
We got the point.
Strength. Okay. Strength is. Okay. What means Gevura? Judgment. Judgment. Service.
Right.
Yeah. Nikud. Shiva. You know Shiva means? Shiva. Two dots. Remember we learned last week, Tereh, two dots this way? Now Shiva. When you have Hashem's name like this, I'm showing it to you, Yud. Two dots. Hey. Two dots. Vav. Two dots. Hey. Two dots. That means a Hashem's name of judgment. Judgmental Hashem's name. We'll speak how it works right now. These two dots means a lot of things in life. I'll show it to you right now and we'll go next step.
Sorry, what's this called again? The two dots?
Shiva.
Shiva?
Shiva.
Isn't Elohim judgment?
Patience. Patience, patience. Elohim, that we're going to different name of Hashem. So the same name of Hashem, different vowels on the bottom. Nekudot. Each vowel works differently.
What does Shiva mean?
Name. Name of the vowel. Yes, Shiva. Now, Gevura Nekuda Shiva, Hanichtevet Gam Ke Shiva. It also write like this. You write sometimes Sheva like that or Sheva with a vet. Sheva means person in captivity. Captivity. Judgment. Sheva means name or Sheva means captivity. Or tell me when I say judgment, I mean what? Fire or water? What do I mean?
Fire.
Judgment means what? Fire or water?
Fire.
So like down. Sheva could be sometimes. Oh, sorry. I need to see. I like to do everything. I made mistake, both of them. It's with Aleph. Sheva, and here also Aleph. Sheva stands for Va'esh. Rabbi Elon. What means Va'esh and?
Fire.
Va'esh and fire. What means Va'esh and fire? Means Shva stands for fire. Yeah? Fire. Now, I want one special Sidur. Do we have special Sidur in here? That has names of the Sfirot?
It's in Reina, we are in the one that you got me from Israel is going to be there?
This one should have, yes. One second.
Yeah.
Give me a second, guys. I'm sorry. I like to be more specific.
Is it the Shabbat one?
No, that's the right one. The Shabbat one is the true. What's up?
Look the Yaakov was up with some.
Yeah, guys, come through.
Guys, come closer. Zalma, where did you say it was?
He said,
no spoilers.
That's your life. It's your future, bro.
Okay. Very good. When you pray, Reina v'anyenu v'livar evenu, o ma'er le'galenu g'ula shlem alaman shmecha, kel go'el chazak et ha'baruch ata Hashem go'el Yisrael. Over here, you have to think about some stuff. For example, what do you think about over here in Bracha Reina v'anyenu? So let me write re'e na ma'onenu. In bracha, re'e na. In Shmona Esre, when you read re'e na ma'onenu, what should you be thinking about? A, cure sick people. Right now. Cure sick people.
What's the catch? I thought it was
Patience. It's anything has to do with judgment. That the judgment, when a person is sick, is in the, under the judgment. Or somebody is in prison, that he should come out from prison. Somebody, God forbid, has in a court case. The court case should be successful. Write down, court case. Or prison. Or woman who's expecting. When woman expecting, the baby is in prison. You know that, right? You know, sometimes when a woman gives birth, they say bracha, huh?
The brachot in the morning. Isn't there a blessing for releasing us from prison?
Yes. But here, in this kavanot, when you pray this bracha, you should be thinking about those stuff.
Is this not the same thing as that?
No. It's like, you know, Bin Zabak, the trailers, they carry gas on top. How many tons they have? 30 tons? 300 tons? I don't know. 30 tons. If his own tank is empty, he's still going to get stuck. Even though he has so much over there gas, he needs to have here. Whatever we say in the morning, that's option. You understand? He is specific in Shmona Yisrael. Chachamim gave us here to think about all those stuff. Here for easy labor. Right now, easy labor. Now I'm going to put for you some new things that you never thought about it, because I never thought about myself. I didn't even know. A, B, C, D. A.
Always be closing.
B, C, D.
Rabbi, I'm sorry. Which bracha is this kavana in?
Re'ena v'onenu.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Rabbi, doesn't it make sense that healing people should be refaino? Just because I don't like to be confused.
I'm explaining you. One more time. When somebody's sick, right? Uh-huh. You pray for him to get cured.
And you're fine.
Yes. You say, Hashem, please give me refuah shlema.
But this is before that.
You're bothering me. You have to learn how to have patience. Okay. I'm showing you how tefillot work in life. This is why we pray every single day. Even though yesterday Hashem didn't listen, tomorrow's going to listen. How? Rabbi Binyamin, even though I prayed yesterday, my tefillah was not accepted, I should still pray tomorrow. Why? Because this angle, that angle is different angles. Look at this. Somebody's sick in a hospital. Here's him. He's sick, okay? Okay? He's sick in the hospital, lying down. Here's his head. Sorry. Okay? He's sick. You pray for him. Hashem, cure him. Here. But when you pray like this, it doesn't work. Who's that?
Some people are watching you on the Zoom, Rabbi.
Thank you.
They're not okay with live.
Why? It's too expensive, right? Okay. Sorry. This is direct. Doesn't work. When you talk about him curing, doesn't work. Why do you have to talk about him as if he's in prison? Here. Now you come from here. Hashem, if he's in prison, take him out.
He's being judged.
Which bracha is that? Here.
Second one.
Hashem, cure sick people. Why? Because he's under the judgment. Court case, heavenly. Should they leave or should not? So now you're not praying about him. Hashem, sick people with... No. Hashem, those in the judgment right now, make the judgment so... Hashem says, this way you're coming now. It's a different angle right now. Amen. This is why we pray differently. You know why? Because how you pray today and how you prayed yesterday is two different prayers. Your mood is different. Your age is different. Your day is different. Your time is different. Fixing that you could do today in life, you cannot do tomorrow. This is why when you're today 13... This day will never, ever in your life will come back. So appreciate the moment and gain the moment. When you learn this moment, that's all you gain. You fix that time. If you don't fix the special time, no one in life can change your spot. Everyone is individual in this world. Everyone is nipaftarima, how they say in Russian. Everyone is unique. And what you could fix, nobody else can fix. Nobody can fix. If you had opportunity, certain time to bring a child and you didn't, no one in life will bring that child. If you had opportunity to save somebody and you didn't at a certain time, no one can save him. It's done. Let's say if I'm a surgeon for the heart and I don't do opportunity of the operation on the heart now, a minute later that person dies. That's all. It's done. It's done. Somebody else will say, oh, you know, I'm going to save tomorrow another person. You're right. Another person, but not this person. This was the father of certain kids and you didn't save him. Chassid Shalom. You understand? Everything is unique time, unique place, and you are unique yourself. This is what Torah teaches us, to believe in anyone about everyone. So now, so this is why we are coming from this view now, on the sick person, or person goes to prison, or person is in labor. You know, originally, if you look at the bracha, Refaenu is the bracha number 8 in Shmona Esrei. So why? We pray so baby who's born to have easy brit milah. Yeah, but what about the labor? Labor is right now, you know, okay?
So we're praying for the woman's ability?
We pray for everybody, everybody. For example, you're praying for somebody who cannot be Jose Bichua, the whole family, religious, one kid. He says, I don't believe in Hashem. Everybody says Kaddish for my father. I'm not going to say Kaddish for my father. I'm not going to go to Shul. I'm not gonna... And you pray for him. You know, suddenly something sparkles in his head and he goes to Shul. What does that mean? What do we call it? He was born yesterday. He was born today. He's born. He's 30 years old, 40, 50. So but he's born now. That's that. What changes? Reina,
Vonien. That wasn't with Bina also, with the Tzere? So that...
Different.
Today we're talking about this. I don't want to mix everything, right? Because I don't want to get anybody mixed up. Next. Now I want to ask you a question. What means anger? Judgment. What is that judgment? Judgment, usually we talk about angry. He's angry person. What means anger? Anger is metzumtam. You know what metzumtam is? Everything put together. When I'm angry, like I'm in my hands, like grabbed up, you touch me. Like, you know, too tense. Everything's inside. But when you calm, like you spread, how are you? I'm good. And someone, okay, don't bother me. Like, you know, you don't get angry. You don't get, like, you know, but when you all put together, it's wrong. Judgment. This is when you see that you're too tense, say, stop, calm down, sir. Why? Too much judgment, no good. Only was good for who? Yitzchak Avinu. Why? What judgment does? Judgment is like this. It's not on the path of chesed. It has chesed, but it's not chesed. What's the difference between Avraham Avinu and Yitzchak Avinu? Avraham Avinu is unconditional love. Somebody comes to you, stuck on your face. You say, oh yeah, give me one moochie. I want to give you a kiss. Hello, this guy's just trying to slap you on the face. I want to love you. You're good. I want to give you a hug. This is Avraham Avinu style. And therefore he gives to Ishmael, Johnny Papa, Pashalster, Anna. Okay, here. I don't want to keep Shabbat. Bachavot. I don't want to keep Kashrut here. I don't want to make brachot. Still, Yitzchak Avinu says, what? Come over here. You make brachot, I give you food. You don't make brachot, I'm not going to give you food. Judgment, which is also kindness, but judgment. You deserve, you get, you don't deserve, you don't get.
What about Esau?
Huh?
What about Esau?
Can I tell you something?
It's trickery.
Thank you. Thank you. You made me to bring out the big key of a Pesach night. How do we say on Pesach night? You sit by Pesach night and say, we have four children. Echad, chacham, one is genius kid. Echad rasha, one is evil. Echad tam, one is simple. Echad shenei de'elishol. That's not what us. What does that mean? Echad, 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 echad. What is echad? He says, Mefarshim say, every child comes from echad. Every child that you have in your house comes from one God. You have to love your child no matter who he is. Yitzchak Avinu did who he was, but when he saw Esav has to be in his house as Hashem, I understand it's from you, and I will respect him as is. But I'll tell you one thing that you should never forget in your life. Child like Esau saved us. When Jewish nation did golden calf, sin on a golden calf, Hashem came to Avraham Avinu, Hashem said, Avraham, your son sinned. He said, sinned? They deserve to die on your holy name. Hashem said, old person didn't help. So Hashem said, Yaakov Avinu, you had sinned to me. What should I do? He said, Hashem, kill them all for your holy name. He said, aha, old person didn't help. A father of 12 sons also didn't help. I thought he's going to give. So Hashem comes to Yitzchak Avinu. Yitzchak Avinu, your son sinned to me. What should I do? He says two questions, Hashem.
Which one?
Question number one, he said, I don't understand. When they got the Torah, they're your sons. When they sin, they're my sons. What is that, Hashem? Make up your mind. They're my sons or your sons? Number one. Number two, he says, I know who's my son Esau. Did you ever see me go and choke him? No. I didn't choke him. I didn't kill him. I still let him be. Hashem said, since you let your son let be, I will let my son to be. So you see, because of Esau, we were saved. So therefore, you don't understand the reason why they had Ishmael and Esau. Everything comes from Hashem. So therefore, but it doesn't mean if your son doesn't listen to you, say, oh, everything comes from Hashem, let me go back to sleep, I don't need to do nothing. No, you need to do as much as you could. And you have to pray for your children until your heart beats. The Stipler Gaon would say, I still pray for my son, Rav Chaim Kanievsky, when Rav Chaim Kanievsky was 59 years old. He said, I still pray for my Gadol Ador. He said, I still pray for my son. How much more we should pray for our children to be in the right path. Now let's go further. Now, what is Din? Din is Metzumtam, Tzimtzum. A, it is what?
Constricted.
I said that all together?
Constricted.
Constricted. I'll write it down if my English, you know. Constricted. Constricted. Tense up. Calm down. No good. Next. What means Din? Kvishata Yetzer. It's called Kvisha. You know Kovesh is when you take Salon Aguti, you put in the thing and you, how you say that?
Lock it up.
Seal.
Marinate.
Pickle,
thank you. Pickle. You know pickle means? Pickle means Kvisha. Kvisha is to pickle. Anger. You have to take it. And you have to question it, exactly. And you have to pickle it. How do I know this? To control anger, I need to pickle, because what Pirkei Avot says, Ezehu Gibor, who is strong, HaKovesh Et Yitzro, who pickles his Yetzer Hara. You have to pickle Yetzer Hara, put it in the box, close it up, say, I don't want to explode you, I want to keep it up, that I should keep you controlled. Midato Shel Yitzchak, this is Yitzchak Avinu, and therefore, this is science for Shamayim. Now, I want to show you something beautiful. Sheva, put it together. This is what? Sheva. It comes like that. If this is Aleph, Sheva is over here. Under it, two dots. These two dots will show you a lot of stuff. You ready? Here we're writing down. Number one is constricted. Number two, this is color red. Adom. Sheva, two dots, is red. Red is the color of judgment. Very good. Next one. Kishura lekabalata Torah. These two dots connect you to what? Kabalata Torah.
Accepting
Torah. I want to ask you a question. Do you see this accepting Torah in these two dots?
Yeah, the two aseret that the brother Hashem said.
Huh?
The two aseret that
two luchot.
Two luchot. Very good. Second thing is, if this is Hashem, this is us. We want to be under Him. To get the Torah, you have to be aligned to Hashem. How do you call that you are aligned under Hashem? Huh? Straight under Hashem. I say straight Yashar. Yashar under Aleph Lamed. Yashar El, what is that? Yisrael. This is why we call it Israel. Because we're trying to be under Hashem. Next. Zivug. Now we're talking about. How you say Zivug? Soulmate.
No.
Those who wants to marry your children, guys, in this bracha re'enavonenu, have kavana. If this is my son, this should be his wife. And if this is my daughter, this should be her husband. Soulmate. Pray for the soulmate over here. Okay? Next. E.
water.
And also it has to do with hearing, Shmi'ah. Person should be able to listen. Sometimes people hear you, but they don't listen to you. Listening. Next. And also, it compares to rain and fire. Rain and fire. Why do we need rain? I know people from New York have vaza in Russia where they plant fruits and they bring to New York and sell it. Or not only New York, the whole world. What?
Or the basi.
Or the basi, whatever is this. Kazakhstan, Pakistan. I don't know this stuff. He knows it.
God bless these guys.
Lamai said, they need to pray for rain to come and heat on the field. Why? When there's more rain, there's more fruits. Next one is fire. Fire also, bracha. Be'orcha nireh or. In your fire, Hashem puts fire. And the last piece, before we continue, this is has to do with the left arm. This bracha has to do chesed. Last week we went to the right hand. This week is left hand. F G. Left hand. Somebody's left hand is hurting. Have kavana in bracha reinam onenu. Hashem, please.
Shoulder hurts.
Cure, huh?
Shoulder.
Shoulder person has to do my macharonim. Why? It says, Tekef, Katef, that's right. But also, Reina Vonenu and Bracha of Chesed. Okay, guys.
Rabbi, a good question.
Yes, sure.
Shabzelot, my machronim, Shalek, Dozhnich, Hamid Ruki, Hamid Chilecham, Bekat Amazon, correct?
Da.
But the word my machronim Chova is a translation for like a degree Torah, no?
Okay. Ma'im Acharonim Chova is the shortest halacha in Shulchan Aruch. The words. But according to the Torah, person should wash his hands before he starts the meal, during the meal, and after the meal. Because Pasuk says, Ve'it kadishtem, ve'item kedoshim, ki kadosh ani. Hashem says, be holy, remain holy, because I am holy. First washing hands is Netilat Yadayim. Middle washing hands after fish, we wash Mayim Emtzayim. And the last one we wash, Mayim Acharonim. So these three washing corresponds to the Torah law. But the phrase that we say, Mayim Acharonim Chova, to do some Divrei Torah by the table. But really, you have to wash hands no matter what. Why? Because when a person eats, there's a decree under Sodom salt. If Sodom salt, this is from Mirtvi Mori, I said Dead Sea. The whole city of Sodom went under the ground to the Dead Sea. This is why nothing grows there, because there's no bracha of growing things. So Hashem said, if this salt touches somebody's eye, that person could get blind. So therefore, we washing hands by Macharanim in order to prevent ourselves from the danger of the blindness. Okay? And it cures person's shoulders. Next one is...
What is EC?
Huh?
What is EC? Hearing.
E-hearing. Guys, tell me one thing. The next week, we'll be learning about Cholam. Cholam is the dot on top. Did you ever see like this letter? Vav, right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. If you have dot on top, is what?
Oh.
What if you have dot in the middle?
Sure.
Ooh. What if dot on the bottom?
E.
E. Now, I want to ask you a question. Before we go, I just want to give you a hint for next week, how crazy stuff are coming up next week. What is this dot on top? Cholam, right? Cholam. Cholam. Who knows Hebrew good?
Ilam.
Right away, tell me which word it comes in your brain. After, huh? Rabbi Ilan. What comes cholam in your right? What comes to your face, to your head, in your mind, huh? Chole,
safe.
Guys, come on, come on.
Dream, dream,
huh? Dream, chalom.
He said it.
Cholam is chalom, dream. Do you know something? This, that on top corresponds to dreams. I never knew this. I want to share with you before we start the session. Ready? Huh? You want to see it? When you sleep, what happens to your soul?
Goes up.
Where?
Shemayim.
This is where you make a mistake. What? Very good. Your soul, when you sleep, goes over your head and watches you. This is your soul. Watches you. Do you understand? This is your soul watches you when you sleep. This is Chalam. Chalam, we'll be learning about it next week. And who would be that? Who is this? Yaakov Avinu. Why? Why Yaakov Avinu? He was not a dreamer.
No, he had a dream.
Ah, he had a dream. Very good. We'll go further, Be'ezrat Hashem, next week. Now we'll start Zera Shimson immediately. I hope you guys enjoyed. But before we start Zera Shimson, I want to give you an introduction for Zera Shimson. Introduction for Zera Shimson is like this. You walk in the middle of the street.
Guys.
Rabbi Awadja, careful, I'm talking to you about you. Ready? You walk in the middle of the street. Suddenly, one guy comes to you and slaps you. He doesn't know that you know karate. You know, he doesn't know. He starts out with the wrong guy and slaps you. Suddenly, you're bleeding.
You'll never be seen again.
Listen, I'm asking you, Shulchan Aruch, lo in Shulchan Rabbi Aruch Aram, you with me? You walk in the middle of the street, a guy comes to you, slaps you a certain way that you're bleeding from your nose, and he says to you, stop. I'm a doctor, I could give you one medication, and you will stop bleeding. Are you allowed to take medication from him?
No.
Huh?
No.
Why not? One word.
Put you in danger.
Assault.
Very good. The one who hurts you cannot cure you.